Welcome to the Pasadena Museum of History. The museum is pleased to announce its new exhibition, Starting Anew, Transforming Pasadena, 1890 to 1930, an exhibit that explores the beginnings of Pasadena, who, where, and how they contributed to the transformation of the city's beginnings. Between 1890 and 1930, the city grew from a small agricultural community to a vibrant, desirable destination. Many were seeking business opportunities or simply to start anew in the warm Mediterranean climate of California. Also featured are the museum founders, the Fanius family, and their legacy in contributing and supporting the world of art in Los Angeles and Southern California. We'll now speak with the museum curator who will describe the exhibition at the museum. Brad Macneil is the curator and director of education of public programming for the Pasadena Museum of History. Today he's going to talk about Starting Anew, Transforming Pasadena, 1890 to 1930. And the collection features also the Fenius family and the legacy that they left. So Brad, talk a little bit about what visitors can come and experience and see at this exhibit.
Well, the exhibit covers a very interesting time in Pasadena history. When the city grew in 1890, the population was about 5,000 people. By 1930, it was 76,000 people. So in those four decades, there was amazing transformation of the city, and we cover that in the exhibit. People originally were attracted to the area and other parts of Southern California because of the weather and the beautiful landscape. It was known as a place of health. Pasadena developed into a winter resort. So even going back into the late 1880s, people were coming to the Pasadena area in the winter to experience the beauty of the place. In the 1890s, a number of hotels were developed, and there were the big six hotels that were built, and they brought in people from areas like New England, New York, Chicago, Philadelphia. Wherever it was cold, they could come to Pasadena and experience a beautiful, warm winter. These hotels would attract these tourists, and they would come for the season. They were wintering, kind of a fun term. Mm-hmm. But they would come in November, and they'd stay till about March. And many of them would stay months at a time. Others would come for shorter periods of time. But these were grand hotels with all the amenities. And the city just kept growing and growing and growing due to the resort hotel business, but also marketing by the city leaders. So to get people here, why they came, we had what was called the Board of Trade. Today it's the Chamber of Commerce. They created a campaign of sending out pamphlets and information, letting people know how healthy and beautiful the place was. Added to that was the hotels doing their own marketing. The big thing that happened was in the 1880s, about 1886, trains came in. You had the railway that came into Pasadena, and that made it very easy for people to come. Well, the railroads did a lot of marketing and advertising, too. Then you had things like the Tournament of Roses, the Rose Parade, which today, of course, is known throughout the world. But that was started in 1890, and people came for that, and also the reputation of having a beautiful flowered parade in the middle of the winter. It sounded pretty good to people freezing in the snow back east, and so that attracted people. So there were all these forces that were inviting people to come to the area.
Besides it being a winter resort getaway, let's talk about the development of the industries and small businesses that were opening up, entrepreneurship.
Well, yes, indeed. There were the people that came as tourists for the resort hotels, but there were also the people that stayed and became permanent residents. Pasadena is known for its Millionaires Row. It used to have mansions all over. It still has many left. But say, for example, the museum is located on Orange Grove Boulevard. That was one time it was Millionaires Row. There were 52 beautiful mansions here. So some of the wealthy tourists decided to become permanent residents. But beyond that, many more residents came for the opportunity. As the city is growing and with needs for city services and amenities, if you were an entrepreneur and you wanted to open up a business, if you wanted to open up a market, or if you were a professional and you were a architect, were a builder, or if you were a doctor, were a lawyer, there were jobs here. Even as an unskilled laborer, there was plenty of work here. So the vast population, the vast majority of people were not the really wealthy. They were middle-class people who were attracted for the same reasons. They came to Pasadena. They fell in love with it. They saw there was potential to build a business and have a good life. They came and they stayed.
So in a way, what's wonderful is that the exhibit displays a lot of this change and development that was happening. There are photographs of in their small businesses, and some of them are still here today.
Yes, indeed. A lot of the materials in the exhibit, as you mentioned before, are from the museum. They're from our library and archives. We did most of our research in our own library, and then we used our archives and collections where we were able to bring photographs and artifacts to use in the exhibit. We also use a lot of video, basically using our photographs in the exhibit. So if you want to walk up Orange Grove Millionaires Row in the early 1900s, you can do it. If you want to see some of the grand, what I call extraordinary excursions that people used to come here for, that includes the famous Mount Low Railway that went up into the Altadena Mountains above Pasadena, the Costin Ostrich Farm, where millions of people came to see how ostriches were raised and be able to buy ostrich feathers and eggs, or the Busch Gardens, the famous Adolphus Busch of Anheuser-Busch built beautiful gardens that was open to the public from the early 1900s.
A lot of this is in your archive department, which is a treasure of the Pasadena Museum of History. So this exhibit has given you the opportunity to pull out some of these stories. This covers who, where, and why people moved here.
Exactly. This is an overview. There's so many stories that are interesting that occurred during this period of time. The archives, we consider them a little gold mine. And anybody interested in the history of Pasadena or surrounding areas, the West San Gabriel Valley, our archives are free, open to the public. Our days Thursday through Sunday. And so anybody who wants to explore in more depth can do so.
So let's talk a little bit about Eva Fenyes and her husband, who came here in the 1800s. And actually, the reason the Pasadena Museum of History is here is because of this legacy.
Well, yes, Eva and the doctor are part of the story. And they came to Pasadena in 1896, a remarkable couple who had met in Cairo, Egypt. Eva was a divorcee, and she was traveling through Europe and ended up in Cairo and met the doctor. They fell in love. They married in Budapest. They started a long sort of honeymoon around the world. And they heard about Pasadena. So they arrived by train, stayed in one of the grand hotels for a couple of nights, explored the community and said, "We're staying. And we are on Eva and the doctor's estate that was on Millionaires Row." So we have the mansion, which is part of the exhibit, actually. But to see the full range of the exhibit, you need to visit the Fenyes Mansion. And there, when you walk in the door, you're in 1910 on Millionaires Row in Pasadena.
And part of the exhibit also covers the evolvement of the art movement here. And Eva, being an artist, some of her work is on display. So let's talk about the art movement and the beautification of the city.
Well, Pasadena became a center for artists. There were, you know, as people look at the art world in developing California, there were different centers. You could have Santa Barbara, San Diego, Laguna Beach, Well, Pasadena was a major center. And again, just like if you were a talented architect, if you were a talented artist, you could come here. And the tourists loved to buy souvenirs and artwork, and then later the residents. So you had a real colony, many artists, male and female, who worked in the city, and craftsmen too, who could sell to the public. So there were art schools, there were art clubs. Two famous clubs are the California Art Club and the Pasadena Society of Artists. It was a great place for an artist to be.
As far as the beautification project.
Yeah, the City Beautiful movement, which actually came out of the Chicago World Exposition in 1893. And it was a movement that said, if you make your city really beautiful, it will uplift all of the residents. So a lot of Pasadena residents visited the Chicago Exposition. And some of you might have heard about the White City that was built for the fair there. Beautiful architecture, Beaux Arts architecture, plazas, fountains, and the influence of the City Beautiful movement moved to many different cities throughout the United States, Pasadena being one. And because of the City Beautiful movement, we have a lot of our great public buildings in Pasadena, our whole civic center, with the City Hall, our beautiful Central Library, our Civic Auditorium. Those were all came out of the City Beautiful movement.
So Pasadena was sort of an inspiration to construct a city that would have not only the natural beauty surrounding it, but the architecture. There are many, many beautiful architectural buildings here.
That is true, and I think Pasadena is known for its diversity of architecture, many different styles, so that we had great architects. We also had dreamers, very talented people that were attracted to the area that had vision. They wanted to make Pasadena one of the most beautiful cities in the world, and they looked to Europe for inspiration. You had people like George Ellery Hale, the famous astronomer, and he was a mover and shaker in the City Beautiful movement. You had a lot of local clubs, societies that influenced the City Beautiful movement. They all came together and made this happen really in a 10-year period. Many of the grand buildings, the finalized ideas in the 1920s, but they'd been bubbling up since the 1890s.
What's wonderful about Pasadena is today it still has a great sense of community. This is really a great city to represent what Los Angeles and Southern California became what it is today.
I agree with you. I think it is a story of California and Southern California particularly. You can find parallels in other cities. I was born in Pasadena and lived here all my life. I had to sort of move away and come back before I really appreciated how unique it was. It's inspirational what people can do when they come together and with a common vision. And you can see that in the growth of Pasadena.
We are excited to present this exhibit. And Brad, you give tours if people are interested.
We bring about 3,000 local students through the museum each year. We invite you to come as an individual or with family and friends to the exhibit. If anybody's interested in a group tour, they can contact me through the museum and we can set that up.
How long will this exhibit be up?
It's going to be up until July 3rd, 2020. We wanted it open through the whole school year because we are bringing lots of students to learn about their city's history.
Thank you so much for sharing this information on this current exhibit.
Thank you very much.
To learn more about the Pasadena Museum of History, go to PasadenaHistory.org, where you'll find information on current exhibitions, programs, events, and more, including a link to the YouTube channel for current and future podcasts. Thank you for joining us at the Pasadena Museum of History.